that was suspenseful. I wasn't sure if he was going to say yes or no, you guys.
Keep them on their toes. Keep them on their toes. All right, so we're going to do something. This is going to be kind of a fun one because even though we'll take you step by step through a drawing, and I hope you'll join along. Grab something to draw with, something to draw on. Back of an envelope, ballpoint pen, doesn't matter. And I'm going to take you step by step through this, but this is a thing where you could do multiple drawings with just this one little shape. And I'm going to show you this shape real quick. It's sort of like I don't know what you'd call it. What would you call this shape, Kim? Like a thimble, right?
Yes.
It's like a thimble. It's like a staple, an N, an upside down U, whatever you want to call it. So basically, I'm going to draw a series of those. I'm going to erase this one for right now. But I'm going to draw a series of this basic shape. And I'm going to draw three. And I'm going to stagger them out a little bit here. And again, the placement on these is really not that important.
Okay.
But what you can do then is then we're gonna put little wings on the bottom of each. Okay.
You know what this reminds me of now is those things that you do croquet.
Oh, like wickets?
Yeah.
Is that what they call them? Wickets, maybe?
But obviously that doesn't make sense because the things would be down in the ground. But for some reason, they kind of remind me of that.
All right. And then, so we're going to now continue this sort of shape. So if you see this, I'm going to draw lines down here. And now we almost have this very similar shape. Mm-hmm. Like they're stacked up on top of each other here, right?
I think Paul is wondering if it's a dill hole.
It's not a dill.
I think Paul likes this word.
I'm sorry, Kara. It's new favorite word of the week. There. Okay, then we're gonna do the wings out again, but only on these top two, and then we're gonna bring down that. It's kind of like steps in a way, right?
Yeah.
And basically, what we're doing is we're gonna draw. Let's see. This might kind of pull it together.
I think Kara called
it. Oh, yeah. Kara's already got it good, so I don't have to try to pretend that you don't know. So then I'm going to draw like little sandcastle here with these little up and down, right? This everyone knows this is sort of the universal
sandcastle
top of the wall
yes.
thing. And then down here, what we can do is, so these are basically what we just drew is almost like buckets or solo cups stacked, right? And so you could draw a sandcastle that has 10 of these towers. But you see, we've got this one in the front that we're gonna the smaller one is like the front one. So we're gonna kind of stack it and we're just gonna kind of draw the sand in here and it could be a little clumpy or whatever. But then you can kind of see there, we have already got some depth going in here, right? And so then I'm gonna draw some windows in here. And again, you can make the windows whatever shape you want, whatever size you want, however many you want. Give it more of this castle look. And of course, it feels like there always needs to be like a little flag. Stick and a flag.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And I'm going to actually put two on here. Lines and triangles, right? Now, to give it the sand sort of texture, what I like to do is just draw little dots. Now, you don't have to go overboard and do it over the entire thing. I kind of do it in the area that maybe is a little bit shaded, so it kind of gives you a sense of shading as well as the texture, right?
See,
and I might put some random ones
here. That takes some art confidence, because I would have done the whole thing.
And you can.
Okay.
You can. It looks fine without doing the whole thing. Yeah,
so I find that interesting.
The one thing, like this style of drawing that I do in these are very cartoon-like. And part of drawing a cartoon or a comic is simplifying things. Mm-hmm. And so it's not about putting in every single detail. It's giving the impression of what's going on here. Mm-hmm. Now, that's pretty much it. I accidentally put that in the wrong, the color where the line is and the line where the color, but that's okay. It's a happy accident.
As if we didn't know what that means.
Right.
We do not.
Doesn't matter. No. Just different layers. All right. Now I'm gonna color this in here.
It's funny if you like laugh as if we all should get it.
Oh, you guys. Hijinks. Hijinks.
Oh, boy. We got some good little jokes going here. Let's see. Well, first of all, Jennifer Tackett says that their word has been inconceivable.
Inconceivable.
That's such a good word. And you have to have watched Princess Bride, right? Like recently. Is that how this happened?
That is, right?
Because there's no way you just brought that word into your vocabulary without that movie, right?
One of the things I like to say recently, and I don't know where we first heard this, but it cracks me up, is the word, it's unknowable. And I use it in the context of something that is clearly knowable. It's like if Kim asked a question like,
it's true.
How many miles do we have to go to will it take to get there? And I'm like, it's unknowable. And that's just kind of a fun thing.
The other thing that sometimes you'll do that makes me laugh like that unexpectedly is it'll be like a number. And then you'll say, like, what do you say? That's the year I was born or something like that?
Oh, yeah, that's a good one. Yeah.
We stole that from Kyle Sheely.
The other one, yeah. I stole from him is A Story of My Life. And you say that when it's clearly impossible for you to be a story of your life. So, like, Kim would say, like, for all three of my pregnancies was I just wanted to have pickles. And I'd be like, story of my life. So, yeah, that's a shout out to Kyle Sheely. We got to get him on. We've interviewed a few times, but not in the most recent installment of the show.
We have.
Oh, yeah, he did. Yeah, that's right. The children's book. That's
yes,
right.
The pizza.
Cool. Now I can say, go back to the archive. Mm-hmm. He wrote a children's book about pizza with a guy named Andy Pizza.
Andy Pizza, right. That's
all right. Now, you always like the thing about the little small things you can do to take it to the next level, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah. So in this case, again, this may or may not work depending on what media you're using. But in this case, I'm using color. This is digital. This is an app called Procreate on my iPad. So I might take a lighter color, almost like a white or a really light color, and then I'll do dots on this side. And it gives it even more of a sand texture, right?
Yeah, it changes it with the white.
You know, because when you look at sand up close, it's got a lot of different colors, like browns and, you know. Mm-hmm. And then I might take a medium color and then do the same thing that you could do. And actually, you could actually have some fun with it and go really more, get some more colors in there. So this is like more of an orangey color.
They've got like all these cool words they're putting in the comments. I like this. This episode is very educational.
Yeah.
Most of the words I can't read from this far away because there's a lot of letters. In especially riches. Rich, I'm gonna have, like, my eyes are starting to get to that point where I'm like, I don't know if I can read that without squinting and going closer.
Yeah.
Same with Steven, he's putting up a word there.
Get a little well, that's good for the live people that can read all of these, because I can and I've never
right?
heard of any of these words hardly.
It's such a smart group tonight.
Yes. Okay. So there's basically that's our thing. Now,
I love it.
The other
that's
thing
cute.
I might do is go with a little bit of a darker, like in the background areas. That's a bit
a
almost
shadow.
Too dark, but add some shadows back here. So you kind of get things that are usually farther away to be a little bit darker.
Yeah, Jennifer was talking about the depth that you're bringing in with the different.
Yeah, and again, I might make
stuff.
Make
ooh, another shadow.
Little shadows on the one side here. But again, I really would love to see your drawings because I would love to see you kind of like do your own version of the castle and make it different shapes and different sizes. But
I'm done with
like
some seagull poop.
Seagull poop. Well, that's what I want to see from you, Brenda. I want to see your rendition of seagull poop.
By the way,
poop.
This whole time I've been playing with Pokey. Those of you who are old school in our brand and work. I don't know why he's on the table today. Was he here
I
for a reason?
I have no idea.
I don't either. Pokey showed up, guys. I have no idea why he's here.
He's here. Let's see. We've got
this little cute.
Oh, shoot. I forgot. I'm going to see if I can pull it up.
The meme?
No, not the meme. That's later, but I'll show you in a second. So we got a really good one here, Jennifer, from last week of the pajamas, and I love the little.
I told her I want
little pants.
I want those slippers. I want those pants.
Those little pants
right?
remind me of goldfish crackers.
They do.
I'm suddenly very hungry. Steven sent this along with the drums, kind of a combination.
Mash up.
I have absolutely no idea what the reference is here. had a couple things going on.
It's got to be a movie because he's a big movie buff.
He is, and he's very into the nerdy stuff, which I think of myself as pretty nerdy, but I think there might be a there was something else in here that didn't kind of got cut off. That was a Monty Python reference.
Yes.
So maybe it was that. But anyway, he's always coming up with some clever things. And then Martha, this is from way back.
So cute,
this
Martha.
little monkey circus.
He looks like he's like moving. She really got that. Yeah. She nailed it. Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm.
And then so this is the one that Mike sent us that's actually animated. And I meant to put it up. So it's not animated right there. I'm going to see if I drop this in here, if it will actually do it. So we're doing this live.
This is live stuff. Oh, sweet.
Oh, there it is. I don't know if they can hear. I think you can hear me right now. Maybe. At least you can get the vibe.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I love these. Don't be afraid. True colors. Yeah. So it's not exactly. It's kind of cut off and wonky.
Mike has taken.
He sends us animated things every once in a while.
He is like going all digital with this in a cool way. So very cool, Mike.
I wanted to show that off. I forgot to make its own slide.
Right, he's getting the love because that's pretty sweet.
Pretty sweet. Pretty sweet. I always love when he sends things along. So please send us your sandcastles. I want to see how they turn out. Unicorn poop or no. Send it to kj@escapeitallhood.com. That email. Did I say unicorn?
Yeah.
Seagull. I meant seagull. Oh, unicorn. That's fine. That's cool. Send them to kj@escapeitallhood.com. That email goes to both of us, so we both get to see them as they come in.